Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumbo.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Picked up a cool trick when I was down in Plano, Texas last week doing a series of seminars. Now, this trick is related to the problem, the fill handle. Put in January and grab the fill handle, it fills in all the months. But if you put in 1 and grab the fill handle, it just fills in 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. All right, so I always have workarounds for this. And there's a lot of different workarounds I've seen. Some people say, put in the 1 and the 2, select them both, grab the fill handle and drag, and that will extend. That works. You can also right-click the fill handle and drag, and then from this box, choose Fill Series. That works. You can left-click and drag, and after you're done, open the autofill options and choose Fill Series. But I always thought the fastest way to go was to hold down the Ctrl key. Hold down the Ctrl key and drag, and that will automatically fill the series. That's the one that I like. Another way to go, instead of putting the number 1 up there, let's put the formula equal row of A1. And of course, as we copy that down, it changes to row of A2, A3, A4, A5, or simply put a formula up there of equal 1 plus H1. All right, so we have a common problem that has struck many of us, I'm sure, the 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and many different ways to solve it. If you think about it, it's interesting that if we put in room 1, a little bit of text, it automatically extends to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I was down in Plano, and someone on the right side of the room in row 2, her name was Priscilla, raises her hand with a way that I've never heard of before. She said, oh, you need the 1 to extend, just put an apostrophe before it. Put an apostrophe before it. Well, that basically makes it text, right? So now that it's text, you can just simply extend, and just like the room 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it does 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then what do you do? Well, you use this little symbol here and say convert to number. And bam, you're done. So yet another solution to this problem that's been dogging us for a long time. Love it. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.